Hello, my followers to the world of sommelier. This is your guide, Corbreaker. Okay, so apparently I opened these beautiful wines and found out that my micro doesn't work.
Houston, we have a problem.
So sorry for this one. Tonight is the second episode from the series 10 years in the bottle of wine. And the second winery of this project is called Madonna del Latte and its wine Sucano. And this time we are heading to central Italy, Umbria. It is a less popular region, so automatically it is a bit more difficult to get the vintage information compared to my last video about Saint-Emilion. And another difficulty to overview is tonight's vintage 2019, because most of the vintage charts last vintages are at least 3 years old, in this situation 2018. So I can only trust Robert Parker, who gave 92 points to the Tuscany Classico, closest thing to the Umbria 2019, and 94 points to the 2009. Thankfully, today's winemaker Leon Zwecker, he kindly shared detailed information about these vintages, so let's compare them to the Tuscany Classico. Vintage 2009 has a label of being strange, because there was a lot of heat in July and August, and then the temperatures dropped drastically in September. So because there was almost no rain, winemakers had to reduce the crop to push the chosen ones to full maturation and concentration. And to save those grapes from the mold spread, they had to circle around the vineyard and cut out the moldy bunches. But overall, the wine came out quite delicate with 13% of alcohol, and to not overpower wine too much with oak, they aged the wine for 24 months in second and third use French barriques. And 2019, just like in Tuscany, was one of those seasons every producer enjoys. There were no strong rainfalls in spring, and all the way to November, there was only heat, sun and hot weather. Perfect conditions for Cabernet and other heat-loving grapes. And we can see the difference in the wine, because this time it is more powerful, full-bodied, with solid 14% of alcohol. And this time, 30% of oak was first used barriques just to back up the wine's muscles with some oakiness and also to smoothen it out with more micro-oxidation. Heading to the winery, the ancient estate of Madonna del Latte is located between Orvieto and Lebolsena. Winery was founded in the year 2000 by food and wine writers Manuel Azzardo and Helmut Zwecker, and now is managed by Helmut and his Lithuanian girlfriend Ruta. 4 hectares of organic vineyards are located in the Orvieto region. Because the owners are not locals, their wine is also not traditional, and the best examples are made from Viognier and Cabernet Franc grapes. Another wine which they are very proud of is Orvieto Classico Superiore DOC. It is the most famous white wine from the area, made from local Grechetto, Procanico, Druppeggio, Verdello and Malvasia grapes. But massive production of this wine affected its quality. And like in most situations, smaller producers are trying to bring back this mineralic and unique wine to the top shelves where it truly belongs. So what happened during this decade in the winery? Well, since 2007, they were busy converting their vineyards into organic, and it took more than 10 years, so vintage 2019 was the first result of it, and in 2020 they became an official certified organic winery. Another addition is installation of photovoltaic solar panels, so now the winery runs on solar power and hot water supply is covered by it. And last innovation is a high-tech closure for the wine bottles called Ardea Seal, which guarantees the wine quality in every bottle. And because this technology was installed only a few years ago, they kindly sent me 2 bottles of 2009, just in case one of them will be corked. Look at it. It is the past and this is the future. Which vintage was the worst for Sucano wine through this decade? Well, according to the winemaker, there were few. In 2017, all the Cabernet grapes were destroyed by hailstorms, while 2013 and 14 were too cool and rainy to get the Cabernet to the full maturation. So no Sucano within those 3 vintages. Talking about the best vintages, like in most of the world, the last 4 years were one after another beautiful vintages for winemaking in Orvieto. So let's taste and find out how volcanic soils full of magnesium and potassium affect Cabernet Franc grapes. Starting with 2009, it has medium plus intensity Garnet color in the nose. Medium plus intensity aromas of sweet and ripe raspberries, red cherries, cranberries, dark chocolate, wet wool, vanilla, violets and mint. In the mouth, medium plus acidity, delicate and tiny tannins with medium alcohol. On the palate, cherry stones. And the younger brother, 2019, has medium plus intensity ruby red color in the nose. Darker aromas of black cherries, plum jam, cocoa powder, pepper, wet soil, new wood. Mouth has medium plus acidity, masculine and young tannins, and medium plus alcohol. On the palate, dark berry sauce waiting on the plate for that duck breast to be cooked. For the conclusions, 2009 definitely reached its prime and cork held up very nicely, while 2019 has a very high ceiling and all the components show that it is too young to be even looked at. And I think we will see this vintage on Instagram at least after 15 years. Let me know in the comments if you tried wines from Madonna del Latte. Don't forget to like and follow. Salute!